that's just a problem with the coding. They just get stuck on walls. Thank you. gonna do what I should have done years ago. I am more than a robot.
Oh, so amazing.
Mega Man. He who hesitates is lost. We shall return. Thank you. just got stuck. Seven. I went ahead and finished that off when Rob went to bed because he clearly had had enough of it, which has been the case with a few of the times that we played through some of those Mega Man games, and he just was like, I don't want to fight Wily, I'm not going to do that, so you go ahead and do it. I don't know. Closing thoughts about it. I definitely think that Mega Man 7 is one of the weaker games in the series. It's mechanically awkward compared to all the other ones. The graphic style is strange. The sprite is just so large. There's a lot of things going on with Mega Man 7 that I think are just kind of intentionally done to make it stand out against Mega Man X. I think a lot of those choices were not great in hindsight. I think its strong point is the music, as I talked about before. I think it's got great music, and one of the things I was most excited about when we were doing this was playing with that new arrangement of the music, which super awesome. Good job to the guy who did that.
Christoph, right? Yeah.
he's really good at playing guitar. But they're just solid arrangements, so. And it did make the game more enjoyable to have that crazy awesome music playing the whole time. Frustrating fights and just kind of general awkwardness. It's definitely... I think that the first Mega Man is the worst by far. I do think that Mega Man 7 is really... close to being the second or third worst game in the original series. That's that. We'll probably play Mega Man 8 at some point, which Rob has never played, and that'll be something, because Mega Man 8 is the other game that rivals 7 for being not amazing. Anyway, that is that.